Okay, so now I've got these two equations. I can combine them. The first one is obvious. This is the original brightness constancy equation. The second one, after I substitute in the Taylor series expansion, there's a little sleight of hand going on. What I'm doing is I'm substituting for this value. Remember, it says that I can get the location at x plus u, y plus v. All right, I can do the Taylor expansion. So here's the original x, y at t plus 1. And then there is this derivative part, okay? I of x times u, I sub y times v. And I of x is the derivative in the x direction. I of v is the derivative in the y direction. Now, students will usually ask me, wait a minute, is that a time t or a t plus 1?
Is that a time t or a t plus 1?
The short answer? Doesn't matter. The idea is we're going to assume that things are changing so slowly and so gently that the derivative at a particular point is going to be the same whether I look at t or t plus 1. It's a little bit, shall we say, dicey, but actually in the limit it's true, and we only care in some sense about the limit. So taking those two equations, I've now rearrange things. I just moved this part over to here. And then in the next line, what I did was, this is I sub t. I sub t is this difference there between I of xy at t plus 1 minus I of xy at t. Well, what is I sub t? Well, if I of x is the derivative of I in the x direction, and I sub y is the derivative of I in the y direction, I sub t is the derivative of I in the time direction. It's what's called the temporal derivative. And remember, our imagery is now a function of x, y, and t. So I can take a derivative in x, in y, or in t. Another way to think about it is, if I just look at some point x, y, and I see how much the image changes from t to t plus 1, that's my temporal derivative. And then finally, on this last one, you'll see that this here is just Ix times u plus Iy times v, that's just the gradient, Ix, Iy, dotted with however the point is moving, that's uv. So we write that like this, that 0 is approximately it plus the gradient of the image dotted with this vector uv. Uv is the direction of motion. Got it? Cool. All right, keep going. Now, this is approximation. In the limit, as u and v approach 0, now you might ask, how can u and v approach 0? Well, the idea is that in the limit, of course, if t was very small, the amount of motion you'd get would be very small. You would just have the direction. So we're going to assume that they're very small, and we're just going to take this equation directly as is, that 0 is equal to it plus this gradient, and that, written out either above as a gradient or here in algebraic form, that's the brightness constancy constraint equation. Say that 5 times fast. Brightness constancy constraint equation. All right, Ixu plus Iyv plus It equals 0.